You've spent your youth developing into a top world-class gymnast. You're the number one qualifier for today's all-around competition in Brussels, Belgium. Yet, you're the underdog. You've got a problem. The Soviets are here, and in gymnastics, they're almost always the favorites. We'll see if the Italian can prevail this afternoon at the European Cup Gymnastics Championships. Okay, kids, now listen up. Come on, listen up. Hello?
Once upon a time, there was a peasant boy named Julian. And in the 15th century, as the story goes, little Julian came to town with his father. And he was lost. After looking for Julian for 5 days, his father told the townspeople he would erect a statue of the boy just as he looked when he was found. Well, as you can see, his father kept his word. And today, dressed in one of his 153 costumes, little Julian has become a symbol for the city known as the Crossroads of Europe.
Brussels, in the center of Belgium, is nestled amidst France, Germany, and the Netherlands. History has rolled over it century after century. For instance, Napoleon met his Waterloo just outside of town in 1815. Near the shining symbol of the 1958 World's Fair, the men's all-around competition of the European Cup Gymnastics Championship is underway. The all-around, 6 events today, the highest cumulative score wins the title. In the qualifying field, there are some new names, but 3 of them will clearly dominate. Hello, everyone. I'm Bart Connor along with Kathy Johnson, and there are some new faces at this year's European Cup Gymnastics. And if the training sessions are any indication of what we're about to see, Kathy, we're in for one spectacular meet.
What's really impressive, Bart, is that though these names might not be familiar, the level of difficulty of the top guys is really outstanding. We'll see some of the most difficult and spectacular vaults, high bar release moves, and tumbling passes being done in the world.
And there's our number one qualifier, Yuri Chechi from Italy. He's 21 years old, and he'll have to contend with this young man, Grigory Misutin, who is very, very explosive.
And they'll both have to contend with Alexei Voropaev with his spectacular skills on the high bar.
And first up on the rings, this is Sylvester Cholani from Hungary. This is his favorite event and his best event. He's the Hungarian national champion here.
Some of the special requirements on this event, things the judges are looking for. The gymnast has to perform a swing to a handstand, a press to a handstand, and then 2 other strength elements.
Cholani opens with a kip to an iron cross, and now watch this move. He pulls out of the cross and presses up to an inverted iron cross. Very difficult combination. Those, of course, are 2 of the strength moves. He needs to show swing to handstand. Here's a nice combination. And his 3rd strength move, and then 4. He even overdoes the requirements. That move there is the press to handstand, fulfills the final requirement. Here comes the dismount.
Full twisting double back and laid out position, a very nice routine bar.
Strong finish for Cholani from Hungary. He's our first performer. Now we go over to the floor exercise. This will be Yuri Chechi. He's our top qualifier here, but not necessarily the favorites. Of course, the Soviets, always the favorite at every international gymnastic competition. Score for Cholani was a 9.7 on the rings. Yuri Chechi has really looked focused in his preparation for this competition, Kathy.
He's already made quite a name for himself internationally. He's had several international competitions. He was 5th on this event at the World Championships.
He opens up with a double backflip in the laid out position. That's the straight body position. Let's see if he can maintain good form. That's the toughest thing to do on this move.
Beautiful form and an excellent landing.
His 2nd tumbling run. Nicely done. Boy, he's so clean. Keep in mind the judges are looking for a routine that is 50 to 70 seconds long. The gymnasts need to cover the complete floor area, show a strength move like this one here, plunge, press to a handstand.
He has a nice 3rd pass right here. Front pike through the layout front somersault.
He really has a nice, smooth style. He never seems to be in a hurry. Here's a requirement. A balance on 1 foot. And you heard the bell in the background. That signals that there are 50 seconds complete
He has 20 seconds to finish the exercise. And a laid-out double back dismount. Strong finish for Yuri Chechi, his first event. Let's take a look at the body position in the air on this laid-out double, Kathy.
You can really see how he lifts his arms right out of the back handspring, which gives him the lift necessary to get that around and maintain a layout position.
9.5 seems a little bit low over there.
I think it's very low, Bart.
Well, the scores are tight. Grigory Misutin will be up on the pommel horse when we come back. Men's all-around competition, the first rotation. This is 20-year-old Grigory Misutin from Lugansk in the Ukraine. The judges require the gymnast to touch all three sections of the pommel horse. You'll notice Misutin does this several times as he traverses the horse. There's a nice move. Although he's doing a lot of difficulty, Kathy, he really doesn't have the long flowing style that we've seen from some of the Soviet greats like Filozerchev and Artyomov.
He's not quite as smooth, and he doesn't swing as high above the pommels.
There's his handstand, a little bit of a bobble there. That'll be a minor reduction. He looked a little bit tight. Of course, the pommel horse is a very difficult event to start off because it really is a nerve-wracking event. And this is one of the best parts of the routine. This move is called a spindle. He's twisting his body back against the direction of his circles. It was a move invented by Zoltán Magyar from Hungary. In fast speed, actually, is a better opportunity to see how complex this move really is. Gotta have quick hands. And the score, 9.65, a good start for Misutin. Even though he was a little tight, a strong score in his first routine. Now over to the rings. This is Voropaev from Moscow in the Soviet Union. He's only 18 years old, and boy, is he strong.
One of the most impressive aspects of men's gymnastics, Bart, is the strength element. And he begins this routine with several strength moves.
Watch this combination. He opens up with an iron cross. And he'll turn sideways to an Olympic iron cross. Then to the other side. And then the fourth iron cross and a pull out to an L. Impressive strength work to start that routine. Once again, the judges require the gymnast to show swing to handstand like that, and the press to handstand. And one more strength move, an inverted iron cross.
There's beautiful control on this event.
Setting up the dismount.
It's a laid out full twisting double back. Very nicely done, just that slight little hop.
Kathy, what's most impressive is he's just 18 years old and he's incredibly strong in the upper body.
And his air awareness is also impressed, Bart. It's nice to see this in slow motion to see where the two somersaults are and where the twist occurs.
Strong dismount there for Voropaev, 9.7, his score on the rings. That'll put him in a tie for first place with Cholani from Hungary. Misutin with a 9.65 is third. Yuri Chechi from Italy, a 9.5, he's in fourth place. Now, while we're changing rotations, let's take a moment to get back down to the fundamentals.
If you analyze the sport of gymnastics, it really comes down to two basics, handstands and somersaults. And since gymnasts spend half their lives upside down, it's pretty important they master both of these.
Now, everyone recognizes this as a handstand position, but not everyone can see it as it frequently occurs in a series of gymnastics elements. Keep this body position in mind and add to it the second basic element, the somersault, or on the floor, it's known as a roll. It can be done as a forward roll or a backward roll.
Or it can even be done in the air. It's called a back flip or a back somersault. Not bad for an old man. Now let's take a look at some of the most difficult gymnastics moves and simplify them by looking for the handstand positions and the somersaults.
Let's take, for instance, some of the routines we've already seen. This was Misutin on the pommel horse. You wouldn't expect to see a handstand on the pommel horse, but remember, there it is. Then on the still rings, Voropaev, you expect to see a handstand on the still rings. Certainly that's a major part of this event. There's the handstand. How about the somersaults? Right there, a double front within the rings in a piked position. Back to a handstand. The basics.
And on the floor exercise, you'll see handstands and somersaults throughout the entire routine. Every time he places his hands on the mat, he passes through a handstand. And there's the somersault, twice around in laid out position. And here's the somersault going forward, right here. Piked position, now piked into a layout. Now look for the handstands, here they are. Handstand, handstand, and a double somersault.
By now, you're pretty good at spotting the handstands and the somersaults in a series of gymnastics elements. Can you see the handstand in this picture? Now keep in mind, to a gymnast, standing is nothing more than a handstand upside down.
Back to the competition now. This is the second rotation, Yuri Keki on the pommel horse. He's got a very difficult opening combination, some one pommel work right here. Three moves in a row on one pommel. Oh, he's scrambling a little bit. Had a minor form break there. Now he's got the rhythm. Notice he's moving a little quicker. His body elevation above the horse shows good extension, something the judges are looking for. He really has nice toe point and really tight leg form. That counts for a lot as well. And a strong finish through the handstand for Keki. Remember, he had a 9-5 in the floor size. He'll need a bigger score than that if he hopes to keep up with the Soviets. We'll be back. Here at the European Cup, an update. Yuri Keki's score on the pommel horse was a 9.6, and Cholani from Hungary had a 9.25 in the vault. He had some problems there. This is Grigory Misutin from the Soviet Union in his favorite event. He opens with a back roll to an iron cross. And this combination here, I feel, is the most impressive segment of his routine. Straight body plunge, and then he presses it on up to the handstand.
Bart, his body alignment and physical strength is just phenomenal on this event.
He has fulfilled requirements of swinging to handstands and pressing to the handstand. Here's the dismount.
Wow. Oh,
full twisting double back. Beautiful laid out position. Crisp, clear twist.
9.8 is the score for Misutin. Terrific performance there. Now over to the vault. This is Voropaev, his Soviet teammate. And this guy can really fly these vaults, can he, Kathy?
We are certainly in for a treat here. He's doing a full twisting kazamatsu, which is actually a double twist in the air on the after flight. A lot of trick to this vault.
Voropaev, our co-leader, had a 9-7 in the rings.
There it is. Oh, a little low on the landing. He really powered his way through that vault. I think we'll see on the replay that technically it was really not that well done, but he's so strong. You can see the legs separate right here. But he just cranks it and manages to come out with a pretty decent landing.
He really did drill it into the floor, Kathy. His score, 9.5, just a little bit low on that landing. Now that 9.5 will drop him down to second behind his Soviet teammate, Grigory Misutin, and Yuri Keki from Italy has moved up to third after two rotations. Much more gymnastics to come from Brussels when we return later on. Back in Brussels for the European Cup Gymnastics Championship, we're ready for the fifth rotation in the men's all-around competition. After four rotations, the Soviets are 1-2, Voropaev and Misutin. From Italy, Yuri Keki is in third. It was very competitive during the third and fourth rotations. Let's look back.
Yuri Keki, who is in third, moved up to first place on the strength of this performance on the rings. This was in the third rotation. Keki showing all the strength elements that have made him a European champion and bronze medalist in the World Championships on this event. He continued to show the judges perfect body line. Notice the clean control of the rings. Tight body position in the handstands. And a big dismount. And with a 9.85 in that event, the third rotation, he moved to the lead. Then in the fourth rotation, he got bounced out of the lead, back down to third place. This is his weakest event. He had trouble rotating this vault. Then he's in the air. A short landing, a 9.45, moved him back down to third.
And also in the fourth rotation, the standings took yet another turn when Voropaev impressed everyone on the high bar. It began with three major release moves, the most impressive one right here, a double back over the bar. It continued on to two more release moves, back to back. It was truly the highlight of the meet so far. And his beautiful dismount was certainly the exclamation point of the routine that put him back into the lead.
So Yuri Chechi getting ready to perform on the parallel bars in the fifth rotation here. Yuri, well known for his powerful physique, we asked him about his training table diet.
This is the problem. This is the problem because in Italy, it is very, very good. Spaghetti, macaroni, lasagna, oh my God. And this is the problem. I must be very attention in my food because I like very much to eat Italian food. Oh, when I eat too much, I'm fat.
Yuri even told us that his worst problem is avoiding his mother's house for dinner before a major international competition. Well, he's fit here and ready to go in the fifth round on the parallel bars. A reminder, he's still in third place behind the two Soviets. On the parallel bars, keep in mind the judges are looking for underbar work, like here, as well as above bar work, shown there in the handstand.
The most difficult part of his routine comes up right here. It's a double front. Watch for it. Right here, into a straddle cut.
Yuri shows a move here called a back toss. It's from handstand, a somersault, back to handstand. Nicely done. Solid dismount. He knows it. That was a key performance for Yuri Chechi. Not necessarily his best event, but he's going to score well there.
Now watch here. The gymnast really has to get his legs up into the somersault to make both somersaults around.
And a score of 9.85, a key performance for Yuri Chechi. A lot of support there from his family. His girlfriend has the flag. She's waving it.
And this dismount deserves a second look. Look at the pike position, so tight, legs straight. And you can't do the landing any better than that.
Well, that's a score to beat in the fifth rotation. The pressure is back on the Soviets. He's here at the European Cup Gymnastic Championships. This is Grigory Misutin, up on one of his more spectacular events, the high bar, Kathy.
He's very capable of a high score on this event. He opens with a skill called the Gaylord One. It's a front flip over the bar. Right here. Oh. Oh, no, he's too far out.
Now, what happens is he loses 5/10 of a point for the fall. He has 30 seconds in which to re-chalk up and continue his exercise. Let's see what happened here, Kathy.
You could see that when he released the bar, he was too far over already. Just couldn't get his hands to the bar. And mentally, Bart, he already knows he cannot win this competition now, but he wants to stay in the top three.
He's already given up a half a point. He has to continue his exercise from the point where he fell off.
Here's his second release move. One arm giant to a ginger. Oh, he has a nice flair to his work. And he has a sensational dismount coming up, a triple back. Watch how he keeps his knees together throughout the entire three somersaults.
Unfortunately, that's not going to be good enough because of the fall early in the routine. That's going to be a major deduction.
You can see here, right as he releases the bar, he's gone too far over, so he just can't get back to the bar to regrasp. But the dismount was sensational. Look at the form on every single rotation. Count them one, two, three, and sets it in for a very nice landing.
9.2 is the score for Misutin. That'll bounce him out of the leader position. The pressure now goes to Voropaev, Misutin's teammate. He'll be up on the floor exercise. We watched him in practice the other day, Kathy, and he had all kinds of trouble with his opening tumbling.
It's a full twisting double back, and he was having trouble staying in the floor area. As you can see, he takes it so far back that he can't land inside the bound.
He's just really too powerful, isn't he?
Shame.
There's the head Soviet coach, Leonid Arkayev, offering some advice.
You could see they'll try and make some technical changes here so he doesn't travel as far back and he can stay in the bounds. You could see the coach is telling him to lift his hips a little more forward.
Well, he almost got it right.
He landed inside the bounds, but it's a very low landing. Of course, that would be a deduction.
And he certainly wasn't pleased with that. He'll be up on the floor exercise now, and let's see if he can get it together. This is the time it counts. He'll need a 9.7 to maintain first place.
He takes it too far back again and steps out of bounds. It'll be a tenth of a point for the step out of bounds.
Watch this move.
Double twisting, double back. That is so difficult.
Not only is he incredibly powerful, but his basic tumbling mechanics are impressive. Handstand has a nice clean line. It fulfills a strength requirement, one of the things the judges are looking for.
Keep in mind how close this competition is. He really could not afford to step out of bounds.
Yuri Keki set the standard in this rotation. He had a 9.85 in the parallel bars, a key performance for him there.
Final tumbling run is a full twisting double back.
And again.
The same problem as the first tumbling pass. He takes it so far back that he can't stay in bounds.
Must be nice to have too much power. Well, Yuri Keki is the man to beat at this point. I don't believe that the score of 9.7 will be achieved by Voropaev. He went out of bounds here, Kathy, and this is going to cost him.
You can see where the problem started. As he lifts into the somersault, he goes too far back. Boy, is it a beautiful skill.
And then once again on the dismount.
The same problem as he comes out of this back handspring. His hips are far back. He goes back. And again, steps out of bounds. That's 0.2 of a point for going out of bounds.
9.2, though. That seems a little low, doesn't it?
That seems very low. The scores have been really low on floor exercise, but I think that's lower than any of them.
And Voropaev can't even seem to get his coach to talk to him. Very disappointed with that performance. The Soviets dropped to second and third. Yuri Keki is our leader, but he's still worried. We'll find out why when we get back. Sixth and final rotation in the men's all-around competition. Alexei Voropaev, 0.4 of a point behind Yuri Keki, and he's on the pommel horse. Voropaev has a nice aggressive swing, good solid body line, but he tends to break form here and there. Typical of the Soviets, he has plenty of difficulty.
You can see right there he had some knee breaks. And again into the dismount. The knees bend, the toes aren't quite pointing.
But in spite of the minor form breaks, a strong finish for Voropaev. But he has left the door open for Yuri Keki, who's about to go on the high bar. Certainly his family feels the pressure. We talked with Yuri before the competition about his favorite apparatus, and to tell you the truth, we got an unusual answer.
Yeah, my favorite apparatus, no, the apparatus that I like more than other is the high bar. But high bar, I can't work very well. This is the problem.
It's strange, Kathy Johnson, that most gymnasts pick their favorite event as their best event. This is perhaps his worst, and yet he says it's his favorite?
I think probably the thing he's most nervous about is a skill called the Gaylord. And he was having trouble after the Gaylord, too. And he was having trouble all through the workout. In fact, I never saw him make one. It'd be interesting to see if he doesn't.
The Gaylord, too, of course, is a 1.5 backflip over the bar with a half turn. It's a really complex move and certainly very risky at this stage of competition. If he does it, it'll be right here at the beginning of the routine. This would be it. No, he's changed the routine. He's going to do a one-arm giant into the ginger.
Certainly playing it a little safe, and actually I think it's the smart move. He only needs a 9.25 to tie and a 9.3 to win.
He has fulfilled all the requirements to this point. Well, come down to whether he can make this landing. A double twisting, double flip. Well done. Even though he took a big hop, Kathy, that's going to be it. Well, we'll just have to wait for the score to confirm it, but Yuri Chechi put it safe and I think played it smart here.
He opted to do a skill that he's done for many, many years, and it's much more consistent. You can see the beautiful lines as he prepares to do the one-arm giant. Here comes the release move. One-arm giant into the ginger. Look how high he is above the bar. Just perfect form. And his score is a 9.7, and here's the official result. Yuri Chechi is in first. Voropaev takes second, Misutin in third, and Bart's with our winner.
Yuri, congratulations on a great win. We noticed as you went into the high bar, you said it was your favorite event, perhaps not your best. You changed your routine. You were working on the Gaylord 2 release move, and you left it out today.
Yeah. In high bar, I was nervous, and Gaylord movement now is not very perfect for me, and it's dangerous again for fail. And so I have preferred the Gaylord, my normal exercise for to win the competition. I think the it's good for win competition. No Gaylord, normal exercise, I can do it, no problem.
Well, Bart, it's been an exciting competition. There were aspects we could have predicted, like the Soviets' brilliance in most areas, but didn't expect some of the mistakes they made.
And perhaps these mistakes can be chalked up to inexperience. Grigory Misutin, he overflew the high bar. Alexei Voropaev, although he stuck his vault, he overflew the exercise mat. But today, it was Yuri Chechi who muscled his way to the all-around goal with consistency on all six events. Well, we hope to see them all at the World Championships in September in Indianapolis. But for now, this red-headed Italian is going home with mom and the family for a big plate of pasta.